Don't forget to press the subscribe button and click the bell icon to stay up to date with all our videos.
Hey everyone and welcome. This project is about how to use Firebase in your React application. Nandesh is going to show you in a project-based manner. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, go ahead and do subscribe it. Follow us on Instagram. And the next voice you'll hear is from Nandesh.
I'll show the demo before going to the coding side. So just we are in the username and the password login, the authentication is this, and you have a sign up. And if you want to sign in, you can go into sign in. First we'll go to the sign up page. First we can create any username and the password because of the sign up. So let me create Nandesh test123@gmail.com password. If you click on the sign up, so it will go to the again welcome screen. So once we click on here, we are in the welcome screen. So again, we have a logout button. If you click on the logout button, so automatically it will come to the sign in again, right? Sign up page. So now we have a one user authentication and the credentials we have, right? Nandesh _test123@gmail.com. So we can sign in that. So I will go to the sign in page. Nandesh _test123@gmail.com. And whatever you give the password, please enter into the password side. So then once you click on the sign in, so we will come to the welcome side. So here the logout we have. So once you click on the logout, it will go to the again there. So this is the video I am going to explain by using the React.js and by using the Firebase. So before going to the coding side, let me tell you what is Firebase and why we are using the Firebase without using the database side and build a database architecture. So Firebase is just a backend as a service. So it is just using, we are using as a backend as a service. It provides the developers with a variety of tools. You understand, right? With a variety of tools and services to help them develop quality of applications, grow their users base and earn profit. It is built on Google infrastructure. It is built on Google's infrastructure. That's why the Firebase is a very extraordinary. We can use it here. So Firebase is categorized as a NoSQL database program. We mentioned in the previously, right? NoSQL database program, which stores data in the JSON like documents. It will store in the JSON like documents. And we have the key features in the Firebase. What are those? One is authentication. Second is real-time database. Third one is hosting. Fourth is test lab. Fifth is notification. So these are the five key features are available in the Firebase. In this, I explained you what is the Firebase and all by the theoretical explain, right? So we'll do the practically by the code. It means by the coding side. How? Firstly, we need to create an React.js application. So let me create one React.js application by using a command npx create React app. Hope you guys know how to create a React application. Login underscore Firebase demo. So it will create an there's a command to create a React application. This is the file name, the project name we are creating, login Firebase underscore demo. Okay, so it will take some time, so let him create. So before in between we can go to the Firebase and we'll create projects. We can use it here. Okay, so here this is a Firebase application. I will go to the from here. Okay, console.firebase.google.com. You can go to directly here and you will get it there, everything. Or you can go to the firebase.application. You can go to the Firebase. Just click on the Firebase in the Google, so you'll get it in this, and click on this Google Firebase by Google. And see, this is the home page we have, what we are getting it here, right? So here, once we'll come to the home page, go to the console side and click on the console, and you will come to the here the projects, right? See that the projects we have already. So just ignore it now. Now I will show you the how to create in the Firebase. So click on the head project. So go to enter whatever you guys need. I will give to the same. So I will create a login Firebase demo. So this is the project I created now. Once you click on this one, continue, enable Google Analytics for this project, create a project. So it will create a project. So it will take some few seconds. No worries on that. Between you go to and check it here, the what happened in the React.js. Yeah, still it is in installing. So we'll go to the again here. And see, now it is a created, right? So your new project is ready with the name of Login Firebase Demo, right? Once you click on the continue, so you can go to the continue there. And here we have a web. See, now we are in the web Firebase Demo project, right? And click on the web and you can register the app. I mean, nickname, whatever you need to give for the app, you want to give the nickname. Give the nickname Login Demo Firebase. Okay, once you click on the register app, it will register the application. Okay, it will take some time, no worries on this. So once you click on the register app, so we will get a one code. See, this is an important in the Firebase. Add Firebase SDK means software development kit. So this is a here, this is a code whatever we have, so we need to copy and paste it in the in our React.js code. Okay, so I will show you the how it will be we can do it. So now what we have to do it now, so we can copy and so okay, you can copy it and here and see, add a Firebase SDK, copy and paste these scripts into the bottom of your body tag, but before you can use any Firebase services. Now it is, these things are there, right? So go to the application, what this is created now, right? So now I mean create React.js, right? Go to login underscore Firebase demo here and start. You can do it and start or npm start, that is no worries on that. So once it is created, so we can have to go to the here. So I mean this is a projects we have, so let me stop. Project is created now and we are running in the localhost 3000, okay, right? HTTP localhost 3000, so it is running in the this one login Firebase demo and it is in the localhost. So we'll go to the projects. Once we click on this, yeah, this will be basic React.js project, will give the UI things and whatever the image we have, right? So let me go to the coding side now. I mean, we'll open in the code. Okay, we'll open in the code, I mean in the Visual Studio. Just click on this code dot. So it will open in the Visual Studio. If you guys don't know what is code dot, to go to the Visual VS Code and install the code. So it will be in get installed. Okay, so now we have the source files here, the source files is there, right? Only the basics files we will get it, app.css.js, app.txt index.js, css logo and something whatever that we have, basics that we will get it. So now what we have to do it, right? So here we got in one SDK, right? So what is that in the SDK? So this is only the SDK we got it, right? So what you have to do it, once you go and copy and paste it, you can just create a one file here. That is, I am calling as a file.js. Okay, so once it is the file.js is created, just copy and paste it here. Okay, so now why this is coming like in this, right? So you have to do the npm install Firebase, npm hi Firebase :: save. So it will be installing the Firebase now. So once the Firebase is installing, so it will be an automatically we can use the default methods from the Firebase, default whatever the we have in the document side, so that we can utilize it and we can achieve the what we are to achieve now. So that is the login authentication, right, with the sign up and sign in, so that we can achieve it. So it will take some time, so let him take, no worries. Is what is this, npm install Firebase -- save. So it is an installed everything, right? It will take some time because some big library. So it is an install with the Firebase version 8.2.0 with 120 packages. So now what we have to do it now, so if we go to the in this, so it will get an, we obviously will get an error because why, this is not an right, this is in, we are created in Firebase in the React application. So what we have to do it first, so we have just copied and pasted from the Firebase. So then what we have to do it, we need to import the Firebase, right? Import Firebase from, if you want to guys any doubts on these things, so I haven't GitHub already, I have created the GitHub in this, so you can just copy and paste it if you need any just code view if you guys need. So just I have created and copy and pasting this one Firebase, these things, and right. So what next? So here this whatever this dummy we already have it, right? So you can't use it now. So what we have to do it now next? So here we have to create a one const fire equals firebase dot initialize app, these things, right? So this thing you have to remove it the script because this is a React.js project. So there is a difference we have, right? So you have to understand these things, everything. Okay. And what we have to do, these things also we don't need. So we can remove it off one by one thing, unnecessary code. So now it is a created now, right? So what we have to do it next? We need to do the export. Export default file, right? So now that's all. So now we have imported the Firebase and we install the Firebase and we are calling the Firebase also, right? Installing the app with the code of these things. So don't use these code only. You can create your own app key and you can utilize on these things, okay, in your project. So if you use these only, so you can't achieve anything. So that's why I'm telling you now. Okay, so now ignore it. Okay, now what we have to do it next? So we can use the login and sign in and sign up screens, right? So first we can do the UI side. So next I will show you the how to the implementation of the login and these things, right? So what we have to do with the next? So we have created the file some rights, right? So now what we have to do, we have created a file.js. So next we can create a login.js, whatever we have in the login.js. Okay, so here is a login. So we have the props and all these things, right? So I will explain once the I will add it in the in my code side. So then before that we need to do the npm install side, right? So now we'll go to the login and click on the raw. If you want to take everything, you can take it and create the login.js. login.js, right? login.js, click on this one. It is created now. Go to the login side and paste it whatever we created from there. So but I will explain, don't worry guys, I'm just copying pasting there because it take quite time. So I will explain you whatever is important and how it is achieving and how it is communicating between that. Okay, so next what we have to do with the, we have on hero.js also create the hero.js. We have created hero and copy and paste it in the here hero.js and paste it. So now what the next? We have the one more file, right? That is, we should be there in the app.js also. So what we have to do, these app.js is the main important things are there, right? I will explain one by one with the point wise point. Okay, don't worry about that guys. So whatever we need here we have, so we can remove it off everything. So we'll paste it as this one. Okay, so what is the next? So we can check it now in the application what we are getting it here. So see, we'll get an error, these things. So we need to check while copy and pasting it also, right? So fail to compile. What is the compile? Fail to compile is there here. Fi.js, right? Module not found, resolve Babylon loader in this login Firebase, right? So we'll do it, we'll install that one, no issues. So before that, whatever we need, we can copy and paste it that. We need to app.css also, right? So we'll go to the here, go back, app.css, copy whatever is there. Yeah, we got in one error, right? So that is now completed. Now I mean, if you guys need help on that, what is the error, if you guys also get that error, so go through this, go this one Babel. I will add this in the description in the comment section, so go through there and then copy and paste this one. It will take some time, I mean it will take some few minutes only to install this npm. So don't worry on that. So you can wait for some time and relax on that time. So you can it will install. So then once installed, just run the app again. So it will create it. Okay, once I already showed that app.css and whatever the things are there, I added it, right? So app.css and whatever, these are the in the source we have, and app.css also we copied it and we paste it in the code side, right? So can you, if you go to the code side here, app.css, so everything is there. So what you have to do it now, what I want to do it now, I need to explain the things, right? So let me explain. First, we'll go to the from the app.js or what I did and all. Okay, just ignore these four files right now, three files. Okay, because right we created that one, right? So import React use state and use effect. Use state and use effect means that is an React hooks. So keep it in mind. Use state and use effect, that is in the, will come in the React hooks topics. Okay. So we created the app and constant app. We can the arrow function, as you guys know about that. And go to the const, create a const, whatever what and all we need. First we need a username and password. We can go to the here, right? We can go to this here, username, password, right? Username and the password, right? And I mean we need one username constant and username password on const. And if we get an error for the username and error for the password, so that const we have to create it, right? So we created username, email, password, username, email, password, right? Email error, password error as account. It means if we don't have an account in the sign in, so that time we have to create one error will come used. That time we can use the state false. So here is an empty. Initially we have to use it as an empty and file says was set as account is then false. Okay. So clear inputs. I mean, clear, once you click on that sign in, so it will clear input, clear an error. That is once const and a login. So once constant angle login. So where it is that? So that is here in this. Okay. So we are imported that login and we have created that. So clear everything, whatever is there here, just you can set it as a props. This is what you will call as a props. Okay. If you go to the login, so we need to, this is a login, right? So we have created the one login.js also, right? So go to the login.js, go to like this, and you will get it here. Here we need to import React from React const login equals props. I mean the parameters we need to props, because from the there here it is getting, right? I mean from there we are getting it, right? From there we are getting the email, whatever the passing the props, that is email, right? One is email. So let me divide the screens now. Okay, login and this app.js. Okay. So email and the one is a email, set email, password, set password, handle login, handle sign up. So everything we have set it as a props equals props. Const, see, const equals and the equals props. Okay. So and we can whatever the HTML things are there that we have to write in the return side. So section class name equals something, whatever the, we need guys, any class name, so you can utilize that's up to you guys. But I give this class names and add it in the CSS, right? Okay. So class names and button container, these are the don't have account and sign in handle function. This is the if else condition, I wrote it there. Okay. So keep it, this is a set as account for a sign up and sign in. Okay. So here the whatever the hero.js is there, right? Here there is a welcome screen. So click on the handle logout. So it will come to the handle logout screen. I mean, now we'll come to the login.js again. Okay. So these are the code base we have. If you guys need to do any code side, so just go to the my GitHub. I will share you guys about that. Okay. So I will make it as a public also. So you guys can utilize and add it in the create these things. And see, these are just a basic explained you. I mean, a basic authentication I explained you. But still, we have a key features. I told the key features of the five frames in the Firebase, right? That is authentication. Now I showed the authentication as well, right? And we have a real-time database, hosting site, test lab, and notifications. If you guys any doubts in that, just create a, just try it with a basic Firebase authentication. So let's do in the next video or in the future, so we can do it as a real-time database, hosting, test lab, and notification. If you guys any important topics we need, just comment in the description. I mean, just comment in the comment section. So then we'll make it a plan and we'll do that. Thank you so much. Hope you guys understand everything. If you get any doubts, if you stuck anyway, so please comment in the comment section. And please share any doubts, any suggestions, anything in there. Please comment in the comment section. And please share with your friends and any families, groups. If you guys any doubts are there, please comment in the comment section. And thank you so much. Thanks for the watching our video. Good luck.